45 yards on this turnover. Actually make that 55 yards.
The big key, watch the hit. Wayne Hampton, Kevin Barlow, you have to catch this pitch. We talked about it again. The ball's bouncing around, AstroTurf, good bounces. Reggie Steven, no stranger to the end zone. Two interceptions this year, he's returned for a touchdown. This time via fumble.
57 yards, remarkable play. And Kevin Bannon, the Rutgers football coach, a basketball coach, would have to like the way Reggie handled himself on that play. Reggie Stevens scoring for the Rutgers Scarlet Knights, so they break on top. If you're Pittsburgh right now, you got to calm down.
And you know what? You can sense there's frustration on this football team, especially on the defensive side of the football. You give your offense great field position, and what do they do with it? They turn the ball over. Not only do they turn it over, they allow Rutgers to get on the scoreboard with a big play by Reggie Stevens.
Conversely, on the Rutgers side, that's could be the play that could really buoy them and maybe get them going. 7-0 for the Rutgers Scarlet Knights. High pooch kick taken at about the 18-yard line, and down he goes. Nice tackle. That was Tosh Riddick with the tackle on Bethea, and that is nicely done. That was outstanding. Good coverage there.
Tosh Riddick, number 6, a wide receiver for this football team, shows his speed. And what happens, Dave, if you're a team like Rutgers, they've already experienced 2 wins this year, they're starting to believe. You know, Terry Shea and all the staff, you know, they were positive going into this game. They could make things happen, and especially how they played against Pittsburgh last year.
So this time, 23-yard line, Brandon Williams in at the deep back. He gets the call up the middle, across the 25 to the 26-yard line. Tom Petko, number 61 there, out of Quakertown, Pennsylvania, sophomore, made the tackle, number 61.
And as you look at the Pittsburgh Panthers offense going back to the huddle, there's really no excitement. It's almost as if they're in shock. You know, we're going through this again. Last week at the University of North Carolina, they lost a hard-fought game that they were in for 3 quarters, 15-10 at the end of the 3rd quarter.
Sure.
Their offense unable to make the plays. Have to make plays.
From the 27-yard line, Lytle's going to throw it. Not too much pressure. Swings it out to his back. Penalty flag on the play. Heck of a move, and then Jabari Moore unloaded. Number 15. They put a major league stick on Brandon Williams. Penalty flag on the play. Jabari Moore, I believe, has got about 7 tackles already.
The guy is all over the field and somewhat undersized, but he loves to play the game. You saw Brandon Williams, the running back, freshman. He was a AstroTurf casualty. You saw that cut. He almost fell down. Turf is very dry, and if you've ever been on it and played, very sticky when it's dry.
Mm-hmm. So the penalty is the Scarlet Knights backing up. Discussing it with Captain Andy Grischkow. Offsides against Rutgers. We apologize for the lack of audio from our referee, Mr. Hennigan. We're working on that. Hopefully we can get that straightened out here at Pitt Stadium later on in the half. So 2nd down and 1 for Pittsburgh. Rim in motion, inside handoff, and that should be good enough for a first down.
That little handoff goes to Ricky Mendenhall.
Mendenhall with the carry, 3rd leading rusher on the ball club, Wayne Hampton, with the stop for Rutgers. What do you do offensively, Jeff, if you're Rutgers? You're talking about, the, you know, they're in a little bit of a daze right now. I mean, they're against the ropes, taking a standing 8 count.
What do you do if you're Pittsburgh?
Pittsburgh.
Well, right now, you got to go back to the basics. They would like to establish the run. That's one thing. Rutgers has been a team that's been, you know, challenged trying to stop other people's running attack. But it's all about young players, running backs, their offensive lines, and experience.
From the 34, that's Grimm in motion. They run it and get it outside. Barlow, nice run up to the 44-yard line. Close to the first down. In fact, he got the first down. Jabari Moore, the tackle once again. So Kevin Barlow racking up some pretty good yardage.
And when he gets back in the huddle, he should pat Chris Schneider on the back. Watch number 32. Good lead block. Barlow is impressive. You know, running inside, physical, 225-pound running back. Right there you see Schneider, number 32, putting Dak Strohmeyer on the ground.
Six carries, 57 yards for Barlow. It's a first and 10 at the 44 for Pitt. Vital. Time over the middle, too high, but the catch made. Great job by Juan Williams, his fifth catch of the season. The tight end out of Jackson, Mississippi. That pass looked like it was a little too high, but the 6'1 Williams, undersized for a tight end, went up and got it.
When Matt Lytle cut this ball loose, I saw no way that Williams would be able to get up and get this ball. Tight ends, they're normally not that athletic. Looks like a wide receiver. Hauls it in, takes a shot. None the worse for it, though.
To the 37-yard line, a gain of 19. Buckeyes on the board. No surprise there. They've dominated Minnesota over the years, and Wisconsin up by 3. Lytle to throw again. Beats containment. Take it down and run. And they take him out of bounds. Carl Mayall, number 99, in pursuit, along with Jabari Moore.
Lytle on a quarterback keeper. Runs out of bounds near the 30.
Not seen a lot of number 99, Mayall. He's out of New Zealand.
But early in this game, we've seen a lot of number 56, Wayne Hampton. Just totally annihilates Ricky Mendenhall trying to block him. Nothing happening downfield. This is probably the biggest asset that Matt Lytle brings to the game. Not only is he a big guy, very mobile, can run with the football. And with this offensive line, he has to.
Fourth in total offense. 189 yards per game. R.J. English is in the game at wide receiver, number 86. A gain of 4. And up the middle. Zion Pyle, that was Kevin Barlow again. Ben Martin, 29, came up to make the stop for Rutgers. And Barlow limping off the field. And one of the things that Walt Harris was concerned about, he says the young man's got to play through pain. He's got to be a lot more consistent. He said when he's healthy, he's a good one.
Gain of 4 on the play. Third down and 3.
Bring up another third down and 3 situation.
Looked like Barlow took a shot on his left knee.
And that's not a lot of laughs from the 30.
Timeout is called by the Panthers.
Not a good sign as Pittsburgh had to call timeout. So the quarterback and the coach will get it together. Lytle no doubt saw something that he was unfamiliar with, and rather than make a mistake, called timeout. And make sure you join us next Saturday for more exciting Big East football action when Boston College, led by conference leader, rushing leader that is, Mike Cloud, steps out of conference to do battle with Navy's exciting option attack. Don't forget next Saturday, noon Eastern, live from beautiful Chestnut Hill, Massachusetts, the Eagles and the Middies. Check your local listings. Let's go down to John Sanders for an update.
Check on the condition of Kevin Barlow. Not playing very well with injuries has been part of his problem. Coming into this season, we've talked about the problems the Pitt Panthers have at running back. They expected him to be the starter, but an attitude problem costing that starting job. He was their only experienced running back coming into this season. He did score 3 touchdowns against Villanova, but the coaches seem to have to stay on him constantly. He doesn't like it. They all get upset, and that is part of the problem for number 43, Kevin Barlow.
Make it tough in the Big East Conference when you're trying to reestablish a program. Walt Harris's club 2-3, 0-1 in the Big East.
But what a breakthrough year last year.
You bet. Let's look at the current drive. The loss, of course, suffered by Pitt in Big East play was to Virginia Tech. That was in their third game. How about that? Now Rutgers calls a timeout.
We're in the middle of a timeout standoff. If you can do it, we can do it.
What do you figure on that from a Rutgers standpoint?
What I would suggest is that Pittsburgh comes back with an offensive formation that, with the people on the field, Rutgers doesn't match up with very well. You're looking at Dennis Crean, the defensive coordinator from Rutgers.
Yesterday we had some time to spend with Walt Harris. We asked his thoughts on his quarterback number 8, Matt Lytle, and what he's got to do today to beat Rutgers.
I've had this strong belief for a long time the quarterback gets too much credit when you win, too much credit when you lose. And he's got to play better, but he's got to get some better help around him. It's hard to play without a good run game, and it's hard to play when your protection's kind of shaky. So he's still got to stand there and deliver the ball and get the job done for us. So.
Pretty much what we've been looking at today. Third down situation coming up, 3 of 7, 42 yards, 1 interception. This time from just outside the 30-yard line. On the sprint draw, and that's not going to get it done. Thomas Petko, number 61, makes the stop for Rutgers. Isaac Williams on the carry for Pitt.
Thomas Petko sheds the block of number 60, Jeff McCurley, the left guard. Just throws McCurley to the side. McCurley in a new position. Switched over in the spring. Last year as a true freshman, started 10 of 11 games at defensive tackle. You know what? McCurley's been on the other side of that ball. You know, you have to ask yourself, they are so short at the offensive line. You know, is this a thing that happened because of the lack of depth at offensive line play?
First quarter's complete. Rutgers leads Pittsburgh 7-0. We'll return in a moment. Pass a couple of weeks ago against Miami. Can be a dangerous receiver. Maybe we will see him a little bit later. He's done a good job on special teams this afternoon. There we go, fourth down situation, 4th and 2 at the Rutgers 29. Pittsburgh 0-for-1 thus far today in fourth down situations. Long count by Lytle. Looking, receiver not there, gonna take it down, run, he gets the first down, goes out of bounds at about the 23-yard line. So Matt Lytle, big guy, 6'4", 2 1/4, run out of bounds by Aaron Brady, first down, Pittsburgh.
And you have to ask yourself, does Walt Harris and this Pittsburgh football team have a place kicker? Choosing to go for it once again on fourth down, Lytle shows you the addition of being mobile, pulls it down, gets the first down.
Talking about the kicking game, Chris Forensic is 1 for 1 on field goals. Paul Rosilla is 2 of 6. So Walt, though, feeling a lot more comfortable going for the offense, going for the touchdown, and now we got whistles all over the place. So another penalty against Walt Harris's club. He's had more negatives today than positives here in the first 15 minutes and 5 seconds.
And a lot of people emphasize the fact, what is your third down conversion rate? I'm convinced the most important down in football is first down. If you can gain a big 5 or 6 yard gain on first down, it sets up your whole entire offensive playbook.
First and 15 at the 27-yard line. Now another whistle. This time Rutgers calls timeout. Goodness gracious. So we'll take the timeout as well here at Pittsburgh Stadium. Dave Sims and Jeff Bostic and John Sanders with you. More from the Big East right after these messages. Look at the first quarter stats brought to you by the folks at Buick. And total yards, Pittsburgh. Look at that, 118. They trail 7-0.
The one stat, 2 turnovers to none.
And the crowd voicing some frustration now. I think that may have been a play clock violation.
Penalty flag on the field.
Boy. Delay of game. We have seen it all so far. We're, honest to goodness, we're only, what's that, as we mentioned, 15 minutes and 5 seconds into the game.
That is unexcusable. You've already had your opponent use a timeout to stop the clock. You're sitting in the huddle, you know what the play is. Get up on the line of scrimmage, you know, get the play called and get it ran. I mean, what they're doing, the offense is moving backwards. I don't even know if the defense can save this offense.
First down and 20 from the 32-yard line for Pittsburgh. This is a drive that started at the Pittsburgh 23. Lytle, it opens up for him, breaks it back right side. That's a big play. 20, gonna pick up a block, 15, 10. 5-yard line, first and goal, Pittsburgh. Big play by Matt Lytle. Ben Martin saved the touchdown, and Lytle's getting up slowly.
We spoke of it early in the game. Matt Lytle is a big quarterback, 6'4", 225 pounds. Wayne Hampton nearly gets him in his grasp, but Matt Lytle has elusive speed for a big guy. 28-yard game. He does come up limping.
He's limping his way to the sideline. And a problem with that right ankle. So a big gain. That brings in Matt O'Connor, junior from Portland. Went to Saddleback Community College. Also was at Portland State. He's out of Aloha, Oregon. And in limited action, completed 26% of his passes. There you go, 4-15, 49 yards. First and goal. Barlow gets the call. Slams down to about the 2. Ben Martin again on the tackle. Number 29, the free safety. Matt O'Connor.
You can see Matt Lytle. Just watch the end of this play. Right there, he kind of gets tripped up. This may be more AstroTurf than anything. Right there, you could see just about the time he hit the ground, his leg kind of flew up, hit the Rutgers defender, maybe just tweaked it a little bit. I would expect him to be back in this game, though.
Second and goal from the 2. O'Connor pitch it to Barlow. Can he get outside? Cuts it up. No, he doesn't get in. Just as he saw an opening, it closed up. Then a loose ball. Let's see. Garrett Shea, number 8, is there. Pitts, Tyrone Pitts. An extra linebacker in the game as well. They're going to say he was already down, so Pitt will have the ball at the 1-yard line.
Big hit by number 38, Tyrone Pitts. Looked like Barlow would be able to get into the end zone. Right at his leg, right here, 38. Face to face, prevents Pittsburgh from scoring a touchdown.
Third and goal. There's a look at Tyrone Pitts. From the 1, Barlow. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Nice hole on the left side. Mark Brown, Jeff McCurley, leading the way for Pittsburgh. So the Panthers are a point after away from tying the score. Barlow's having a great afternoon. 10 carries, 63 yards, and now a touchdown.
Pittsburgh is very much a blue-collar town. This latest drive by the Pittsburgh offense, nothing fancy, very blue-collar. Get in behind the left side. The sophomore Kevin Barlow, the leading rusher for this Pittsburgh offense, walks into the end zone.
Chris Forensic on. Out of Strongsville, Ohio. He's a senior. He's 5 for 5 on the season. And we've got a tie ball game. 13:04 to go, second quarter from Pitt Stadium. An 11-play, 69-yard drive over 5.5 minutes span gets the Pittsburgh Panthers even, but on that drive, they did lose their starting quarterback. We'll see how that plays out when we come back.
The lightweight aluminum in your car radiator is the only thing between you and a breakdown. Put in Presto. It bonds with aluminum to give you a powerful zone of protection against corrosion. Protect your car in the Presto zone.
Before you do this or this or this, you want to have this and this and this.
You'd be surprised how much of our technology goes into your day.
So for this, 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 or this, or this.
We're Siemens.
We can do that.
Can I have your attention, please? You too, driver. What you're about to see on this screen may well change your life. You can be in a Toyota Avalon, a Consumer's Digest Best Buy ASAP, because Toyota dealers are offering you big savings on 98 Avalons thanks to factory-to-dealer incentives. Big savings right now. So everybody, go, go! I can drive this bus. Easy.
Here's the choice for Attorney General. Elliot Spitzer, who repeatedly said fighting crime is not the Attorney General's job because...
I'm a pragmatic liberal.
Or Dennis Vacco. Dennis Vacco tripled criminal prosecutions and helped pass new laws to protect our children and nursing home patients from abuse. Now New York leads the nation in reducing violent crime. It's a clear choice. Attorney General Dennis Vacco, proven crime fighter.
This is Big East football, everybody. Tie game here, 7-7. Kevin Barlow with the touchdown run of 1 yard. Tied up. And for Barlow, big touchdown, his third of the season.
And the big key, watch your left guard, Jeff McCurley. Also your center, Andrew Grischow. Double team right there. Right there, preventing penetration. Take the Rutgers defensive tackle back into the end zone. What happens? Barlow walks into the end zone.
Pittsburgh has dominated in time of possession, yet it's only a tie ball game. Pitt's had the ball 12 minutes to four and change, almost five for Rutgers. Tosh Riddick about 5 yards deep. And they do the prudent thing. Keep it right there. Take it on the touchback.
But the one thing, Dave, that's been the Achilles heel of this Pittsburgh offense all year long, turnovers. They're leading in time of possession, but they're also leading in turnovers.
There's a scoring drive. Pretty impressive. But, boy, I tell you what, both teams, not a heck of a lot of clock management in terms of the use of times out and recognition of defenses. And then the offense didn't recognize it. They called a timeout, so.
First down and 10 for the Scarlet Knights.
Rutgers takes over at its own 20. Rutgers down to one timeout remaining here with just under 13 to go. McMahon on the roll. Holland down there overthrows him. Hank Poteet covering at the 45-yard line.
McMahon's pass intended for Andy Holland goes incomplete. Hank Poteet providing coverage on the play.
It's a great afternoon here at Pittsburgh for Big East football. Rutgers and Pitt at Pitt Stadium. I'm Dave Sims with Jeff Bostic and John Sanders. 7-7 is the score. Rutgers scoring on a Reggie Stevens 57-yard fumble return. Kevin Barlow, 1 yard run for Pittsburgh. Second down play. Thomas bangs across the 25-yard line.
Thomas on the carry.
Thomas was knocked down by Seth Hornack, number 26, the strong safety for Pittsburgh. Here's a look at Thomas, sophomore out of Salem, New Jersey. He's fifth in Big East rushing this week. 69.8 yards per ball game.
Early in this game, Dave, I'm sure the Rutgers defense would love to get a break. Rutgers needs to convert a third down.
0 for 3 coming into this play on third down situations. A team that's at 43% on the season. That's up from 27 a year ago. Guess what? They're not going to get it done on that one. Kenny Pegram, senior out of Washington. Nice play by number 62. 6'2", 275, a senior.
And you really have to ask Terry Shea, the head coach of Rutgers, what type of confidence do you have in your passing attack, namely Mike McMahon? Third down and 5, you're going against the 9th-ranked defense in the nation, and you decide to run the football.
Titus with the punt, line drive. Poteet's got a return at the 41, and down he goes. Good coverage. Tosh Riddick there. Second time we've seen him make a real good play on special teams. So backup wide receiver really earning his keep today. 33-yard punt, a 2-yard return. We'll return to our tie ball game, 7 up, right after this.
We ease life's pressures.
Working on number 24, Lewis Terso. Big size advantage right there. Terso's only 5'8". First down for Pittsburgh.
Grimm with 2 catches and 28 yards. 13-yarder on that one. In Rutgers territory, Barlow in motion. Here's Lytle. Boy, he's reading his progressions, hangs it high, got a man down in the end zone. Barlow, oh, he had it and dropped it. Should have made the play, was right there. Dante Siciliano, the nearest defender, but Barlow on a nice throw. Good delivery by the quarterback, Matt Lytle.
Good job of number one not panicking. You know, the pocket does not collapse. His offensive line does a good job protecting him. Buying time, sliding in the pocket. Delivers a strike. Boy, Kevin Barlow would like to have an opportunity to catch this one again.
Second down and 10.
Oh, Lytle with a very nice delivery. Second and 10 at the Rutgers 38 coming up. Mendenhall, the lone setback this time. Idle's going to throw it. Blitz. Jabari Moore after him, throwing a catch made. Now they're going to say it was out of bounds. They say the tight end Juan Williams was out of bounds. Dante Siciliano covering for Rutgers.
Speaking of the Rutgers defensive staff yesterday, if they can get Pittsburgh in long yardage situations, they're going to certainly come after Lytle, putting on the pressure. Williams unable to get his foot down in bounds. It's going to bring up third and long. I wouldn't be surprised to see Rutgers blitz again.
Crean was adamant about that. We're going to flush these babies.
But, you know, if you are a team that's given up 26 sacks in five games, why not come after them?
No question. Fourth and seven on third down situations. They run a loop. Lytle hangs in, delivers, got a completion to Murphy. 20. Nice move to the 15. First down, Pittsburgh. Nice play. Terry Murphy on the catch. And for the Murph, another big play for the Pitt Panthers. Jabari Moore finally brought him down. 24 yards on the pickup.
Rutgers chooses to blitz. Good job by Pittsburgh picking it up. Lytle stays in the pocket. The Pittsburgh offense has sorely missed number 81, Terry Murphy. Last year, a Big East record 13 touchdowns for the year. Big play today.
Murphy, two catches, 32 yards on the afternoon. First and 10 at the Rutgers 14. Barlow, the deep back, Mendenhall, the up back. Barlow gets the call. They run left side. Looked like something was there. And then Mike Bell closed it down quickly. Mike, a senior out of Paulsboro, New Jersey, number 94.
Brought down by Mike Bell.
In terms of confidence, Lytle, a couple of these passes he's completed, it's had some time. This and that last one to Murphy had a little bit more time and really delivered nicely. Out of town scores, no shock there. Ohio State second quarter up big on the Golden Gophers in Wisconsin. One of the bigger teams around in front, as is Georgia in the SEC. Second down, 10. Here's Lytle. They blitz on the outside. They throw underneath. They got a man. It's Murphy close to first down. Murphy with an out pattern. His second catch of the drive. Lewis Terso, and they're just wearing him out. Murphy at 6 foot against the 5'8 Terso.
We touched on it earlier. Pittsburgh's offensive line has struggled this year, doing a good job of picking up the blitz. Last play that was completed to Terry Murphy, they bring six against Mike Lytle and the Pittsburgh offense. Able to pick it up. It's all about confidence and execution.
First and goal at the 4. Pittsburgh with 10 first downs to 1 for Rutgers. Pittsburgh going for the lead. Lytle waiting for somebody to clear. He does. Touchdown. It's Murphy. His second touchdown of the season. A 4-yard pickup, and Pittsburgh with the lead, 13-7. He beat Reggie Stevens.
Terry Murphy came into this game with only 10 catches for the year. He's been hampered with a shoulder injury and also a sprained ankle. Looks like he's healthy again. Matt Lytle, we talk about precision passing. He threads the needle. Reggie Stevens, a cornerback from Rutgers. There's really not much you can do, Reggie. That's great coverage. Good concentration by Terry Murphy, gathering the ball, scoring the touchdown.
Second straight possession. Pittsburgh has scored. Extra point tacked on by Chris Forensic. Is good. 8:33 to go. Second quarter here at Pitt Stadium. Terry Murphy fired up. The senior from Los Angeles has given Pittsburgh the lead. We'll take a timeout and see what kind of response Rutgers will have. Lytle, nice delivery on the touchdown pass.
When you're renting a car, you don't always want to drop it off where you pick it up.
And with National Car Rental's one-way rate program, you don't have to.
You could
pick up your car in Jacksonville and drop it off in Nashville.
Or pick it up in Los Angeles.
Drop it off in Las Vegas. In fact, with National Special one-way rates, you can pick up your car almost anywhere and drop it off almost anywhere else with no separate drop-off fee. So what are you waiting for?
We never thought we'd use OnStar for snakes.
I just hate snakes.
Yeah, traveling through Arizona, we blew a front tire, shot off the road, and I looked down at the ground. It is crawling with rattlesnakes.
It was unbelievable.
I pushed the OnStar button. Within seconds, the OnStar advisor pinpointed our location and sent a tow truck.
Call the paramedics.
Yeah, and kept talking because we
hate snakes.
Yeah.
Now, get the OnStar system and installation at no extra charge when you sign up for a year of service. Call 1-888-ONSTAR-7.
185,000 women will be diagnosed with breast cancer this year. Our primary means to combat this disease is through research. That is why we at the U.S. Postal Service are proud of the